What is the most paranormally active geographical location in the world? In other words, briefly, the area where one would be most likely to see a ghost.
In a graveyard would be the most likely place, where there are those who are resident in the graveyard and not aware that they are, in fact, ghosts. They simply are resident or attached to their body. If you are looking for ghost people, as we would prefer to call them, these can be in the common household, they can be in religious centers, they can be at funeral parlors during the service of one who has just passed. It would be better to add that the most prominent time to see a ghost is in the first week after someone has made the transition, that the physical life has been set aside, and now there is the spiritual detachment. At that point in time, those who are ghost people tend to communicate with others, family and friends. They are attempting to stop their grief or their sorrow, or that there is a possession of their house. In other words, they are deceased, but they still reside in their house, and you can see them walking through the place with a peripheral vision. If you are looking for a specific geographical location, two aspects. One, where there has been great horror, massacres, or some sort of atrocity where large groups of people have been slaughtered. Here there are still residue of ghosts. You can do the same in prisons where there has been years and years of hatred, or where executions have occurred. There you may find also the presence of these ghost people who are permanently or at least consistently earthbound. However, if you look to that, there would be more, look to those spiritual centers in which there would be temples or congregation points, especially in the out-of-doors. Here, those that are of the finer vibrational rate, those that are a little more aware or are, let us say, more loving, they congregate here as well. You might call them angels or ghost people or benevolent souls who are joining in on the ceremony as they may have while they were in the world itself. It depends on the race or the nation where there would be spiritual centers like a basilica, a cathedral, or a temple, or a holy place or point.
Looking over all the aspects, all the areas that you have just talked about, the world over, is there a particular one that would one would be most likely to witness a ghost with their physical eyes? For example, by city or state or province, country, can you locate it in that sense?
Yes, we understand, and our response is that depending on the nation, depending on the religious points of view, it would be at the congregational point of that nation. For instance, all souls don't go to the Punjab, or all souls don't go to San Sebastian, all souls don't go to Mexico City for the Lady of Guadalupe Basilica. However, those nations, those peoples that would have this point, whatever it would be, in the highest regard, this is where you might see spiritual beings to answer the question where there would be a congregation. But you don't need to travel. Look to the funeral parlors or to those who are grieving, and that ghost person will arrive. However, if you are looking for random sightings, they are everywhere, no special congregation, you'll see, unless you are looking for those points where atrocities have happened. These would be the more earthbound and more plentiful beings. Direction.
Thank you. In the same similar vein as the previous question, in which geographical location, we're talking country, city, state, province, etc., in which geographical location would one be most likely to witness a UFO?
Wherever you would find larger deposits of uranium, this would be some indication. And they seem to be from the southern United States to Tokyo, to those places, Syria, and we have also to Argentina in the southern points. You may find also into that of the higher, like Scandinavia, latitudes. They are basically wherever there is congregations, but here, see it more to where there is uranium or high concentrations of metals or minerals that radiate an energy. That is usually conducted in electrical and electronic circuitry that comes from the ground. These points, these places, provide that of fuel, if you will, to these devices, to these craft. They absorb it almost through osmosis, but it is some transfer actually. And out of the force itself provides the momentum to their craft, you'll say. Direction.